The word is simply this. The Lord is my shepherd. It's the beginning of perhaps one of the most familiar psalms, if not one of the most familiar verses in all of Scripture. Written by King David some 3,000 years ago, David describes the Lord with a familiar picture of his day. A shepherd. Of the shepherds are not quite as familiar in our day. Sure, we do have sheep farmers involved, just not always that visible. And should spring decide to actually be here now, we might be able to see some sheep out on a hillside or two around us. Nonetheless, the life of a shepherd is rather foreign to most folks these days. Sheep practice of sheep herding has also become a little bit more advanced and perhaps laden with a few more comforts and conveniences than years ago. So when you hear the verse, "The Lord is my shepherd," it may sound a bit odd for some folks. Without knowing what the life of a shepherd is all about, it's hard for some to understand those familiar verses, let alone find comfort in them. Perhaps some would find more familiarity with the phrase like, "The Lord is my accountant," or "The Lord is my electrician," or "The Lord is my bus driver." But such substitutes always end up falling short. There is something about the nature of being a shepherd that offers the fullness of what our Lord does and who he is. In King David's day, and Jesus' day for that matter, a shepherd was intimately familiar with the sheep. Now, David knew this firsthand. In the days of his youth, he was a shepherd. A shepherd knew the stubbornness and the stupidity of his sheep. He knew their tendencies and their weaknesses. Sheep would graze on the same land until it would be utterly bare and completely ruined, and so they needed to be led to green pastures. Since sheep are not very smart animals, they would also need to be brought to still waters in order to drink. Being covered in sponge-like wool, raging waters would pull them in and drown them in a matter of seconds, hence the need for still waters. So a shepherd had to be vigilant. In David's day, Jesus' day as well, a shepherd would camp out in the wilderness with his sheep. That was a place where fugitives and outlaws hid, waited for the opportunity to rob, pillage, steal, or destroy. The hired hand wasn't always ready to risk his life for his sheep, but a good shepherd was. A good shepherd led his sheep safely through the valleys where shadows hid predators and prowlers. He used his rod to protect them from wild animals and intruders. He had a staff to lead them and to comfort them. He was there to ensure that they would not be in any want. See, this is the picture that David paints for us. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. But then, in the exact center of this prayer, this poem that David writes, a great shadow of all that is wrong in this world is introduced and threatens to blot out the good and merciful presence of the shepherd. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. The shadow of death. Death Valley, you might say. Perhaps it's the darkest shadows and heralds of death. Things like cancer, Alzheimer's, depression, divorce, domestic violence, grinding poverty, or homelessness. All have a way of casting a shadow that brings sorrow and sadness, along with some suffocating despair. But such shadows inevitably have a way of dragging sheep back to the shepherd. This psalm, you see, is a reminder that our lives are lived out in the company of both the shepherd and the shadow. It reminds us that on this side of eternity, we don't get one without the other. You have the Lord who comes like the shepherd, with all his provisions and promises to tend you like sheep and to go with you even though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death. You see, when you and I walk through such valleys, and when you and I are covered by such heavy shadows, we become acutely aware that we are people in desperate need of comfort and hope. We only need to look at the news, or look across the street, or simply look in the mirror to see how sin assaults us and assails us, how evil enslaves us, and how death surrounds us. So like sheep, you're running scattered and scared. So into all of this mess, God sends the Good Shepherd, not the hired hand, the Good Shepherd. He sends him to forgive you, to revive you, to enliven you. Jesus Christ is the Good Shepherd who brings the abundant life to you right here, right now. He does that by drowning fear and despair in the waters of baptism. And then he wraps you in his birth promise and declares that he goes with you through every valley, every shadow. In a world that robs, pillages, steals, and destroys, Jesus camps out with you. He came to this earth, and he walked around in it. He knows its terrors, he's felt its cruelty, he's experienced its unfairness. He was even robbed of the abundant life itself. Crucified, dead, and buried, for the sins of the world, he's felt it all. That is what the Good Shepherd came to do. Jesus himself said it. Listen again, the gospel reading. I am the Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. Who is the hired hand and not a shepherd? Who does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. He flees because he's the hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the Good Shepherd. I know my own know me. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. Jesus, that Good Shepherd, he says, I know my own, and my own know me. In other words, he knows you. Intimately, he knows you. He's the one who at this very moment can come right to where you are sitting. He says, listen, I know you. And I have something to tell you. I know your whole life story. I know every skeleton in your closet. I know every moment of sin, every moment of shame, denial, dishonesty, and degraded love that you've ever experienced. I know the valleys that you travel. I know the fears that you have. And I know the shadows that haunt you. I also know your shallow faith or your feeble prayer life, your inconsistent discipleship, and my word to you is this, trust me. Trust me that I love you as you are, not as you should be, but as you are. I love you right here and right now. I've redeemed you, shed my blood for you, died for you, and rose again for you, so I dare you to trust me. Good Shepherd, not the hired hand who flees at the first sign of trouble or danger, the Good Shepherd who walks right into danger and into death for you. For lost sheep wandering in a desert wasteland of sin, he seeks you out, calls you by name, and wraps you in his arms, baptized into his name. brings you into the sheepfold of his love and compassion. Restores what is stolen and heals what is broken. He meets you in the midst of heartache and misery. He knows what it is. He's felt it. And he brings you through it. No, he doesn't remove all suffering and unfairness. Not yet, at least. He'll do that when he returns to make all things new. But for now still, sin afflicts us, tempts us, and death still has its sting. But you see, he has journeyed through it and brings you to the sure and certain hope, the resurrection of the body and the life everlasting. So we live by faith. And that means we believe Jesus brings real hope and real life to real people, living amid the very real sin and real struggles of life. He brings forgiveness and real healing to you who are hurt by your own sin and who are hurt by the sin of others. Yes, we live under shadow and shepherd. We have Jesus as our good shepherd. To lost sheep and found sheep alike, he is the voice that leads you through life. So listen to his voice. It's proclaimed in the scriptures. It's spoken at the Lord's table, the place where you're going to hear his word say, given for you. There he prepares a table for you. A table, as the psalm says, even in the presence of your enemies. And at that table, your cup overflows. For when you eat and drink of the Good Shepherd, surely goodness and mercy will follow you all the days of your life. That is the comfort, having the Lord as your shepherd. Those shadows about, we live under the love and the protection of the Good Shepherd. Jesus said, now may the peace of God, passes all understanding, guard your hearts and your minds, and keep them strong in that faith of our Savior Jesus Christ, life everlasting. Amen.